But you know, when I get around food, I get into trouble, even when I shop for it. Is that ridiculous? I bought a piece of Romano cheese, say, and this guy at the delicatessen says, lady, because that was a bad guess. I know what threw him off. I was wearing chiffon. I had been bowling. And he says, lady, the longer you keep this kind of cheese, the better it gets. Then he kissed it. You know, I began to wonder how long he'd had it. I know it's dull work, but how lonely can it get? But I felt that he was an authority, so I bought it 4 years ago. Well, the man lied. Someplace along the line, we have passed better. I can't cut it, I can't catch it. But every now and then, I open the refrigerator door and throw it some food. And it's getting crosser and meaner. And next year it has to have a license. Well, I'm scared to death of it. And think of the extra work. That thing has to be aired. The dogs won't run with it. I don't blame him. It's so ugly. It's got this penicillin fur all over. And one lousy leg. And that isn't even in the middle. I take it out, it doesn't know what to chase. I'm the only woman on the block that walks a piece of cheese. Oh, and then Thanksgiving. Worst news. I stuffed the turkey. And that's the last. It took me 3 weeks. Stuffed it through the beak. It was the only thing open. And I was very patient. I sat there with those dinky little tweezers while Thanksgiving went past. So then I decided to shoot for Christmas. And then I got to thinking about the cheese. And we don't have room in that refrigerator for two pets. Because my ironing is in there. It's older than the cheese. All our kids are grown. I got baby clothes in the ironing. The inside of that refrigerator got to looking so bad, I unscrewed the bulb. And now it's very dark and lovely, except I can't see what I'm doing. A friend came over, I gotta tell you this. She wanted a little snack. I went in there in the dark and sliced off a sliver from my ironing. It cuts just like cheese, really. And it looked great on the cracker. She loved it. Dotted Swiss cheese, what the hell? But she called me from the hospital. Oh, my glory! Oh, I couldn't hear. The pumps were making more noise than she was. But I had my own problems with that turkey. See, I had already learned the true meaning of the word foul. So I had to get that thing out of the house. Here's what I did. I hung the body out the window. It was cold, and I shut the window on the neck, left the head inside. I went on with my work. And everything was going great until I get this call from the ugly woman downstairs. Oh, you wouldn't like her. She had her nose fixed, now her mouth won't work. And I think it makes her meaner. And she's on the phone, she says, Phyllis, what is this stuff coming down the side of the building? I wondered where it was going. Nobody told me to sew up the other end. She says, what is this stuff coming down the side of the building into my window and all over my new Bigelow? I was delighted. I said, looky here, you. For one thing, Bigelow should be at work. I said, for another thing, you want to know what it is? Taste it. She did. She flipped. They took her away. I wish they hadn't taken her through the lobby. Screaming for cranberries. She wanted to marry a pilgrim. And I'm right back with the food and drug idiots. But you know what I'm going to do to get them off my back about the cookbook? I'm going to rewrite it into a movie. And I've got one scene already that I'm really kind of proud of. It's the heroine in this scene is spiraling down the staircase, which is straight. The kid is loaded. She's wearing this fabulous two-piece outfit. Spats. And they're open.